my husband and I always had this discussion on the junk drawer. I said, you call it a junk drawer, I call it my essential drawer. Unfortunately, it's an entire drawer that is dedicated to basically what we have right here for you.
Now, I hate...
I need a one-cup serving, quick.
Okay,
I need a three-quarter teaspoon.
Oh, no, I don't,
yeah,
I
don't have that.
Okay, but look, this is the ring that gets everybody crazy. You have to...
You gotta wash them all.
Everything gets dirty.
Or you take them apart and you never get them back on the ring.
Well, you take them apart and then you lose pieces.
Mm-hmm.
So now I'm looking for the one that I took up. Oh, there's... Oh, look.
There it is.
Okay, so... And then things get stuck in the drawer and I have you pull it open and everything gets bad. Okay. I hated that.
Jammed.
So I did this. These are my measuring cups and spoons. Come
before, after.
Okay.
But who's to say this isn't going to become this?
Because all you need is this and this. Watch this. These stay together, but come
apart. Isn't that brilliant?
When you want them to, because there's a magnet in every handle. I know it's hard to see over this white. Come over here. Mm-hmm. You have to stay with me over here, folks.
Okay.
This is where the magnet is in every single handle. This is how they go together. This is how they come apart. You only use what you need. I've also got my magnetic measuring cups and spoons. See, they stay together. They can roll around in your drawer, and you take out the one you want. Let me show you the whole setup down here so you can see it against the screen, because these are white cups. I put color items inside so that you can see it.
Yeah.
Just so you can see it. Here you have every single essential that you would need. On the spoons, there's a tablespoon. There's a three-quarter tablespoon.
Love which is, that. Never, ever had one of those.
Never have one of those. Mm-mm. And that's in so many recipes, I couldn't believe it. You have a teaspoon, a half teaspoon, and a quarter teaspoon. Then we come to my cups. Look at every
look
single
look at all the different sizes
and
of cups
all,
that you have.
And it's all right on the edges of the cups. You will never lose the measurement. You can have them right here. There's a quarter cup right there. There's a half cup. I'm trying to see the
measurement. I can tell you, there's a quarter cup, there's a third cup, there's a half cup, there's a two-thirds cup, there's a three-quarter cup, and then there is a full cup.
Now, those are measurements
that
I found.
Two-thirds, what do you normally do? It's a third and a third. Right? If you have the three-quarter, now you're getting out two, you're getting out the half cup, and you're getting out the quarter cup, and it never ends up with the right measurement.
If you'll notice, every one of my measuring cups are laying absolutely level on the countertop, and you can't get a shot. There you go. Come on. Next shot, I'll show you. See how they're laying level? That means that if you want to measure things into the spoons while they are on the countertop, and this is something that it always drove me crazy. I always got more extract
on the counter. Okay, because now you're trying to hold it, now you're trying to pour it.
Yeah, forget that.
Thank goodness I like vanilla, right?
Now I can
pour
it.
But I might not want so much cumin.
Look. I can do it while it's on the countertop and just leave it there.
Do you see how great that is? As opposed to, look.
Shaky.
So I want you to see. So what do we normally do? We're kind of holding it, or it's here, and then it's tipping over.
It doesn't.
So see how that has that rounded bottom? This is actually, these are actually done in such a way they're going to perfectly line up, and they're going to stay for you. And it has the stability bar that's on there as well.
This is a tent style because this
Smart.
Is easier to pick up than a stick style handle. It is actually designed to be picked up easier. The cups are the
and
same
the cups
thing.
Cups with the flat bottom.
This
Brilliant
is,
design.
And this is also the way. This is a more natural way of picking up a cup than holding onto a little skinny stick. This way versus this way. So I can use these as pre-measure cups if I want to on the surface of my countertop. I can get all my recipe ingredients ready. That's easy. And you can scoop anything from any size container. These are my green boxes.
You need
boxes.
Three cups of rice. You need two-thirds of a cup of rice, your greens.
These are my ultralight green boxes that you're going to see in just a couple of moments, and some spices. So let's go in a spice jar. I can fit this in a spice jar. The reason I made them round is that they actually fit into things, and you can scoop like that, right? So there's a spice
Great
jar.
Design.
Here's a little spice jar. It fits inside there. And then once I measure that, I can lay it down and say, okay, now that's ready for the recipe.
And now I'm not trying to shake it into that area.
So whether you're going to get something out of a box, I've got two cups here. Look at that. See the magnet?
If you are a baker, if you are a chef, if you're a wannabe chef, if you're a foodie, like for me, and then also even getting the things out and prepared ahead of time,
This is.
Debbie and I both said, you know, we both have our issues with having everything done and organized and in control and ready to go. Imagine putting out, you know, you're making that apple pie. You need 3/4 teaspoon of your particular spice. You need a half a teaspoon of your nutmeg. You need 1/4 teaspoon. You can have those already out, and then they lay nice and flat inside of here. Plus, now you're not doing it and scooping it and trying to pat it down.
Yeah, no. One of the reasons I made them round inside is because if you are a baker and you know that baking is chemistry, it is not just winging it.
Better be the right amount.
Sometimes when you use a straight-sided measuring cup, you're actually getting a void in the corner, and you don't know how much flour you're missing. You don't know how much ingredient you're missing. Yeah, that will give you a void. Can give you a void in the corner. This way, when you are scooping. When you're full, you know you're full all the way to the bottom. That measurement is exact.
And by the way, that's it.
That's
no more junk drawer. This is everything that you need.
Just sit it in your drawer.
All in one. Plus the ones that you might not normally have. So again, look at all the cups that are in here. So we go all the way down from the 1/4 cup to the 1/3 cup to the half cup to the 2/3 cup. You never see that one.
Nope.
You also have the 3/4 cup, and then you have the full cup. Same here. You have the 1/4 teaspoon. You have the 1/3 teaspoon. You have the 1/2 teaspoon. You have the 3/4 teaspoon. And then you also have that full teaspoon.
A tablespoon. That's a 3/4 tablespoon. That's a measurement that I find in every recipe, and I was always shaking a little bit out.
Mm-hmm.
All of these cups are all ones that I found in recipes and couldn't find.
That's right. 3/4 tablespoon is what I meant to say.
Like I was doing for certain measurements, I was doing 1/4 cup plus a third of a cup, trying to work out how to get exact measurements. You don't have to worry about that anymore. And they are prep bowls. The reason I originally designed these and invented these was that I was actually trying to teach my son when he was very young measurements. And when I was holding the old style on the table, I was having to put my finger under them to keep them level while he filled them. And I thought, this is ridiculous. Everyone should be able to fill. Look, you see the one that I filled with extract a little while ago? I'm going to pick it up. Look how easily I can pick it up and move it around because it is easy to hold.
Well, and
that is the kind of handle.
Others can kind of help you because maybe you need that. Then you're going to get in here. You're going to go in here.
Mm-hmm.
You want to get that and you get it nice and smooth. You get that right amount.
You can twist into the container.
But now it's ready to go. So when I'm on step 3 of making my pie,
exactly.
or step 4, it's there, and it's boom, 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 boom. You
line things up,
ready to go.
I line them up on my countertop just like this, all the ingredients that I'm going to use. That way I am ready. I'm always prepared for the recipe that I'm making. Sometimes I like to just do things, you know, it just makes things easier for me.
Right.
I always solve my own problems first. You know that. It sounds selfish, but it isn't, because actually I know if I'm helping myself, I'm helping lots of people. Nobody loves the ring. Nobody loves having to wash more things than they have
to.
If I look at the difference, I want that one. I can take out that one. And that's the only one I have to wash. The rest of them go back.
Or I got to go in here and I got to try to detach them. And then I take that one off and I take the one off from the middle and you have it. And then you're like, oh, darn it, I do need the 1/2 cup or whatever. It's right there. And that's all in the drawer.
They can spin around.
And now it's not lumping up.
But they can spin around. They can move in the drawer and they'll still stay together. And even, I want this one. Okay, I need that one right now. I want this one. I can take that out. But when I'm finished and they go back together.
And then they grab each other back in there.
They go right back in their own spots.
But they're also not hard to get apart from one another.
And the whole thing will stand. If you have someplace else, it's not a drawer. If someplace else you want to put it in your cupboard, you can stand it on the shelf.
You know how nice that's going to be on your countertop? If it's for that one day, it's that one meal that you make. Thanksgiving dinner is yours, and it's yours and yours alone. You know how much work it can actually be. This is going to simplify that work. It's going to simplify the prep. It's going to allow you to have it all out and about whenever you want it. Everything that you
I'm
need in here.
Them.
And what do you have? Do you have the metal ones? Do you have the plastic ones? I have metal ones and plastic ones.
You know,
because the one that's on the ring, I never want to have to detach it, because the one time I detached the metal ring, it never went back together.
I have had every kind. In fact, this is part of my old collection.
Yeah, sure.
I've had every single kind there is.
This is what my drawer looks like.
And in fact, handles are all bent because they got stuck in the drawer. I even tried to do an all-in-one, which never works because everything's all dirty at the wrong time.
Right.
All the scoops, all the cups, every kind.
Oh, yeah, the scoops. Those are good.
This is what... I wanted. Now I have all this extra room if I want to put other things in here, other serving utensils, whatever. But what I think is great is if you know somebody who's just starting out, if you know somebody who is a cook, doesn't have to be a baker, any kind of cook, anybody who's interested in getting the right measurements, people who follow recipes want the measurements correct.
I can tell you, buy a couple of sets of these, because if anybody comes into your house and they see you using these, my mother-in-law would come in and she'd be like, where did you get that? And then we've not had these in stock since 2011 was the last time that we offer them. So March of 2011, that's how long it's taken us to get these back in stock. Over 900 of you already having said yes. It's $12.90. Remember, here's what you're getting. Everything.
But think about a Secret Santa. Think about the things that you're going to have coming up. This is also a great hostess gift. If your hostess is someone who's cooking for you, bring them these. If you've got a Secret Santa and you have to spend under a certain amount of money, look at the price, this $12.90. This is a wonderful thing. You can even break it up if you wanted to make it two Secret Santas if you had to. But this is the kind of set that when I was starting out as a young woman with my own place and I was starting to cook and all that stuff, if I had this kind of arrangement, I wouldn't have been trying to buy something to fill the void all the time with other kinds of things. This is all
we're going to go to the phones, and I know we are already very busy. If you want to get yours, we have over 1,000 already gone. We have hundreds of you in the ordering process. Dolores is calling us from Minnesota. Dolores, thank you. Have you ever seen anything like this?
No, I haven't.
Have you ever seen a 3/4 teaspoon?
No.
I mean, 3/4 tablespoon, excuse me. 3/4 tablespoon?
No.
I love these.
I haven't. That's why I'm so excited.
Now, do you like to bake, or what was it about this that really kind of caught your eye, Dolores?
Well, there are more cups and spoons there that are in my regular cups and spoons. Mine are scattered all over the place. I have no idea where most of them are. And I don't have those specific numbers either.
That's it. That's what we said. It really makes a lot of sense because we do have the 1/4 cup measuring cup. We have the 3/4 cup measuring cup. We have a 2/3 cup measuring cup. We have the 1/2 cup measuring cup and the 1/3 cup and the 1/4 cup on the cup. So a lot of times it's hard to find those. You know, when you're trying to go between the 1/2 cup and the 1/4 cup, you figure that's about a third.
Don't do that shaking out business.
When you're making... it makes a big difference. When you need that 3/4 tablespoon, taking the tablespoon and only having part of it, it doesn't work either. So continue dialing. Dolores, thank you very much.